Chris Tulak works at Wizards of the Coast in our organized play department as an RPGA content designer.
Yes.
I got it right. Phew, that only took us 7 takes.
Yeah.
Chris, welcome to Game Radio Zero. Thanks for taking the time. I know
you're really busy,
so I know this is your busy time,
thank you.
Oh,
yeah, this is it.
So how's the con been going so far?
It's been going fabulous. We have tons of people playing Living Forgotten Realms, which is our newest program that we've launched here at Gen Con, and is being played worldwide right now, and it's wonderful. The excitement here is great. A lot of people commenting how positive their play experiences have been here with D&D 4th Edition. It's awesome.
And a lot of people, I mean, there has been a lot of questions about Forgotten Realms.
Oh, certainly.
We've done some interviews with Ed Greenwood and, you know, Rich Baker and everybody else, but I wanted to talk to you as being kind of the expert on what does it really mean to be living? What does living mean?
What it really means is that you're able to take your character and play that character anywhere you want, in any type of environment you want to. If it's a home game, if it's at a game day, at a store, or if it's at a gigantic national convention like Gen Con here, you could take that character, bring that character anywhere, and that character will have an impact on later adventures that come out for that campaign setting and for the world, really. The character has a measurable stake in that world.
So it's sort of almost like a persistent world.
Yes.
You're participating in a persistent world opposed to just your little group. And
Definitely.
So what happens after you guys have an event like this, you run all these things, do you then take the feedback and kind of that community aspect of what people liked, didn't like, and take that into account?
Yeah, definitely. Actually, at the end of every Living Forgotten Realms adventure, there's a series of questions the DM fills out. When they report this information, along with the characters' treasure they gained and their XP and such, we get all that information in our database, and we can then just pull that information and take a look and see, hey, did the majority of the players in this adventure kill the evil prince, or did the majority of the players fail to do so, and did he get away? You know, that kind of a thing, and that can shape the content in the future that we see.
That's very excellent, and for the most part, people have really kind of latched on to this idea,
They
really like that.
Definitely. You know, our previous Living Campaign program, Living Greyhawk, was incredibly successful. Tens of thousands of people playing it worldwide. Living Forgotten Realms is off to a huge start here at Gen Con Indy, bigger than even Living Greyhawk was, and we anticipate many, many more people playing this campaign too as well.
Awesome. Chris Tulak, I know you're busy, going to let you back
to it. Thanks a lot.
Thanks again.
Yeah, take care.